buying house on in a non-Islamic country with a non-Islamic bank, interest-based revised promise problem. And some scholars say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. There's a really a conflict between some scholars. They do perpet it is allowed to give the riba, but it is not allowed to take a riba. That's like saying I'm selling something which is haram, but I'm not taking haram. So this is the same ruling applies here. You're giving a riba, but you're not taking a riba. So this same is it is the same category that this is haram. Regardless, it's you're giving the riba or taking riba, it's the same thing. It's the same thing as like you're selling an alcohol, but you're not taking alcohol. But is it halal to sell the alcohol? No, it's not permissible. This is haram. So similarly, buying a house on a mortgage in with the non-Islamic bank or taking a loan on the interest base or investment or anything which is related to riba, let's make it very simple, this is haram. This is the only sin that has been mentioned in the Quran, that those who are involved in the riba is like waging a war against Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is a Sharia compliant some mortgage companies who does allow with their own planning, but buying a house from a non-Islamic banking, it's haram. This does not justify themselves that they are not taking riba and giving a riba. So this is not permissible to buy a house. Even it's a house, Islamic center, or it's a masjid or whatever, but something based on riba is haram. It's like who are the people are involved in this kind of a sin? Those the buyer of the mortgage and the seller of the mortgage, who write it, who made the copy, who signed it, who made the printing of that, who created an agreement of the riba. So this all they are fall into the same category of riba. Those who are living in the riba based houses, those who have are building their masajid, those who are building their Islamic centers, those who are getting a car on a loan, all they are fall into the same point where the Allah says this is the only sin which has been mentioned in the Quran, that get ready to wage a war against Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because this is an extreme sin. Because the lowest part, the lowest sin of the riba is like astaghfirullah, is like adultery with your own mother. This is the least part of the riba. So those who are involved in selling an investment, selling in a banking, involving in a credit cards, involving in a mortgages, non-Islamic countries, people are Muslims are very proud that they bought their house and they have their own house, but they did not realize, but at the time of Akhira they're going to be the losers, because they are waging a war against Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These houses are haram, these Islamic centers are haram, this massages are haram. This does not justify they are doing some good deed, or those people who bought their own houses is making their own property. They are going against Allah and they are going against the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is not the teaching. So the least sin of the riba is being mentioned in the hadith, that you are doing adultery with your own mother.